As winter's chill does fade away, the starlit river holds its sway. Good morning, today is Wednesday, February 7, 2024. Today in history, on this day, 212 years ago, British writer Charles Dickens was born. Renowned for works such as Oliver Twist, David Copperfield, and Hard Times, Dickens dedicated special attention to portraying the life experiences of the little people at the bottom of British society. His writings profoundly captured the intricate social realities of Britain during his time, making significant contributions to the initiation and advancement of British critical realism literature. Ching Chiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Ching Chiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Malaysian PM Anwar appoints opposition MP to lead government committee. According to Malaysian News, Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim announced during the Malaysia Madani government promotional event that Datuk Syed Abu Hassan would serve as the chairman of the committee to address rising food prices and living costs under the council. Syed Abu Hassan expressed his commitment to assisting the government in organizing nationwide promotional activities aimed at stabilizing the prices of various necessities. Syed Abu Hassan, a member of the Malaysian United Indigenous Party and a member of parliament, declared his support for the Anwar government on November 28 last year, making him the fifth United Indigenous Party member to shift in allegiance while remaining within the party. This marks the first instance of Anwar appointing an opposition MP to participate in government affairs. Syed Abu Hassan hinted that 10 United Indigenous Party MPs might announce their support for the Anwar government and potentially defect before the House of Representatives convenes on February 26. The Malaysian government spokesperson stated that they maintain an open attitude towards collaborating with opposition and other parties. Nevertheless, another United Indigenous Party MP suggested legal action against MPs who have changed allegiance to compel them to vacate their seats. Myanmar sends non-political representatives to ASEAN meeting for first time. In recent news from Luang Prabang, the informal ASEAN ministerial meeting, the first significant gathering since Laos assumed the rotating chair of ASEAN, was convened. The Myanmar military government, for the first time since the 2021 coup, dispatched a non-political representative, with Marla Than Tyck, the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Myanmar, in attendance. Following the coup in February 2021, the Myanmar military leadership reached a 5-point consensus with ASEAN in April of the same year, committing to cease violent suppression and engage in constructive dialogue with relevant parties. However, the implementation of these agreements has yet to materialize. Starting from October 2021, ASEAN ceased inviting leaders of the Myanmar military government to participate in its meetings, instead extending invitations to non-political representatives. Myanmar had not participated until now, suggesting a potential shift towards substantive measures to implement the 5-point consensus. Economists noted that this move indicates a softening of Myanmar's stance towards ASEAN, although it falls short of a significant breakthrough. Compared to previous ASEAN rotating chairs, Laos has been relatively restrained in criticizing the Myanmar military government. Laos also partook in informal discussions organized by Thailand and the Myanmar military government last year. Myanmar aims to end its political isolation in Southeast Asia and return to active engagement within ASEAN during Laos's tenure as the rotating chair. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. First U.S. soldier fatality in recent Israel-Hamas conflict. In recent comprehensive news from Washington, a U.S. military base located in northeastern Jordan, near the Syrian border, was targeted in a drone attack, resulting in the death of 3 U.S. troops and injuring over 30 individuals. This marks the first instance of a U.S. soldier losing their life since the current round of conflict involving Israel and Hamas. President Biden has pledged retaliation. The Secretary of Defense echoed this sentiment, stating that any attacks on the U.S. military will not be tolerated, and necessary actions will be taken for the protection of U.S. interests. Hamas spokesman Sami Abu Zuri interpreted the attack as a signal to the United States, warning of further attacks unless the U.S. ceases actions perceived as harming the people of Gaza, He also cautioned that the ongoing conflict between Israel and Hamas might escalate into a regional war. Prior to the incident in Jordan, U.S. troops stationed in Iraq and Syria had faced over 150 attacks from armed groups supported by Iran. Additionally, U.S. warships in the Red Sea were targeted by Houthi armed forces, also backed by Iran. Jordan stands as one of the largest recipients of overseas military funding from Washington. The country hosts hundreds of U.S. military instructors and engages in joint military exercises with the U.S. throughout the year. Since the outbreak of the civil war in Syria in 2011, the United States has provided substantial financial support to help Jordan establish a comprehensive border monitoring system, aiming to prevent militants from Syria and Iraq from infiltrating Jordan. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. CNN, Philippines ceases operations. In recent comprehensive news from Manila, CNN Philippines has announced the suspension of its operations. Launched in 2015 by Turner Broadcasting System Asia Pacific Branch and Nine Media Company, CNN Philippines served as a free news channel and website, primarily in English. The closure is reportedly attributed to financial constraints and the inability to sustain the costs associated with CNN's expensive brand licensing agreement. Over its 9 years of operation, CNN Philippines incurred losses exceeding 5 billion pesos. This sudden shutdown has resulted in the unemployment of 300 employees. The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines expressed concern, stating that the outage leaves the public without a reliable source of information, particularly at a time when disinformation and misinformation are widespread. Now, here is some important safety information. Deadly attack on Istanbul church claims one life. According to Agence France-Presse, two masked individuals recently opened fire during a mass at St. Mary's Church in the Salia district of Istanbul, Turkey, resulting in the death of one person. Following the shooting, the attackers fled the scene. The police are currently conducting an investigation. Surveillance footage from the incident depicts two men in black snow masks, with their hands in their pockets, one of whom wore black sunglasses. However, the motive behind the attack remains unclear. It is reported that in December of the previous year, Turkish security forces detained 32 suspects suspected of having ties to Islamic State jihadists. These individuals were allegedly planning attacks on churches, synagogues, and the Iraqi embassy. Authorities speculate that the recent church attack may be connected to these activities. Noto earthquake. Nearly 90% of victims perish in house collapses. According to Kyoto News, a powerful earthquake struck the Noto Peninsula in Ishikawa Prefecture, Japan, on January 1. Numerous buildings collapsed, roads were damaged, and the death toll has reached 236. This marks the first time since the 2016 Kumamoto earthquake that Japan has seen an earthquake death toll surpassing 100. Reports indicate that over 43,000 houses in Ishikawa Prefecture suffered partial damage or complete destruction, with more than 90% of the victims perishing due to house collapses. Authorities note that the affected areas have a relatively high proportion of elderly residents and a significant number of old wooden houses. These structures, hindered by financial constraints and other factors, had not undergone proper reinforcement. This is identified as the primary reason for the elevated number of earthquake-related fatalities. Urgent measures are recommended to assess construction quality in other regions of the country while concurrently promoting the reconstruction of the affected areas. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Impressions of Monet, Singapore, hosts art exhibition. According to Lianhe Zaobao, Gardens by the Bay in Singapore has recently announced plans to host an Impressions of Monet-themed exhibition starting on July 12 this year. The organizers aim to recreate Monet's iconic pink residence, drawing inspiration from his paintings. Gardeners will use hydrangeas, weeping willows, daisies, geraniums, and more to replicate scenes from the Normandy Garden and Water Garden. The exhibition seeks to provide visitors with a multi-sensory experience, incorporating sound, light, color, and fragrance to explore the life, works, and inspirations of Monet and other Impressionist painters. Oscar Claude Monet, often hailed as the leader of Impressionism, is one of France's most significant painters. His distinctive style involves redefining the depiction of shadows and contours, emphasizing the interplay of light and shadow colors. Notably, on May 14, 2019, Monet's masterpiece Haystack set a record at Sotheby's auction house in New York, fetching an unprecedented $110.7 million. This stands as the highest auction price ever achieved for a Monet work and the highest for any Impressionist painting. Financial newsletter. According to the Wall Street Journal, the primary contract C2405 for corn futures recently experienced a drop to a low of 2,317 yuan per ton, followed by a broad rebound in prices. The main contract, C2405, subsequently C. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.